Namaste friends, welcome back to the Sarthi technology. In this video we will learn about data classes. So sometimes we need to create a class that act like data, and for that we use data classes. So this data class has ability to print its data, it has ability to copy the data, it has ability to compare and many more things. So we will learn some functionality of this data class in this video. So first thing is how to declare. So declaration of data class is very simple. Just add a data keyword before the class and rest is the same. There are some requirements to be a data class for any class. And here you can see the first is the primary constructor needs to have at least one parameter. So this primary constructor must have at least one parameter. All primary constructor parameters need to be marked as val or var. Okay, so all parameter needs to be var or val. And the third is data classes cannot be abstract, open, shielded or inner. So if these requirements will be fulfilled, then we can create a class that will be data class. Okay, so let's dive in the practical. Here main function, and first let's create a class, for example person, where name, and name will be string, comma, where age, and age will be int. Let's add body. Okay, and here create an object of this person class, where person1 equal to person, and here the first parameter is name, so name for example Ram, and age is 25. Okay, now let's try to print this person one. So println person one. Okay, let's run this. And here you can see the output person at then some number and letters. What if we will put data keyword here? Again run this, and now you can see the changes here. Person, this person is the class name, and in the brackets the name equal to Ram and age equal to 25. So this is the magic of this data keyword. Okay, now let's add another value in the body of this person class, that is where contact number int, add initializer, that is 0, and let's create another object of this person class, where person 2 equal to, and we can copy the value of this person 1 in this person 2, and for that person 1 dot copy. At this time all these value will be copied in the person 2. Okay, but if we want to change something from this, then we can provide that here. For example, age equal to 30. In this case, the value of this age variable will be 30. So println person 2, and let's run and here you can see the person 2, the name is Ram and the age is 30. Okay, so you can use this for copy. Now we can also compare, and for that if person 1 dot equals person 2, then println both objects are same. Else, both objects are different. And let's delete these two print. Okay, and run. And here you can see both objects are different, and the reason is the age of this person 1 is 25 and the age of this person 2 is 30. So let's delete this. Now age of both persons are same. Again run this. Here you can see both objects are same. Now what I want to show you, if we will change the contact info. So here contact number person 1 dot contact number equal to 2323 and person 2 dot contact number equal to 5252. Okay, now the contact number of both persons are different. So let's try to run this. Again, you can see the result, both objects are same. However, the contact number is different, but the result is both objects are same. And reason behind this is the Kotlin considers only this value that are available in the constructor. Okay, so at the time of comparison it will check only this value. So as per this value, the name of this person 2 is also Ram and the age is also 25. And that's why this result is both objects are same. Okay, so friends, this is enough for this video. If you have any doubt, then you can write that in the comment box below. I will catch you in the next video. Meanwhile, please like this, subscribe the channel and also share this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next. Till then, bye.